our next guest has been changing lives around the world with audience readings from the other side. She is a medium like no other. Take a look.
Born in Birmingham, England, Lisa Williams has an extraordinary gift passed down to her from her grandmother.
You look nothing like the lady in Poltergeist.
As a psychic medium and healer, she travels the world providing answers to questions only the spirits could know.
And I just saw a little boy and a girl poking their head out there.
Through successful TV shows and tours, she's developed quite a following and was recently ordained as a faith-based minister. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the extremely gifted Lisa Williams.
Lisa, welcome back to Studio 10.
Thanks.
Which of course you knew I was going to say.
Yes, of course.
How old were you when you first started seeing spirits?
I think I was 4 years old, but according to my mum and dad, I was much younger. I thought it was normal to see dead people. Mm. You know, you would at that age, so it was very normal for me.
I thought it was just Hayley Joel Osment who could say that.
Because was it your grandmother who you inherited your gift from?
Yes, my grandmother had been doing readings for some time at that point. My grandfather died and suddenly she could come out the closet. And ironically, I have to tell you this, the church fate wanted to raise money. And she said, I'll do psychic readings. Well, you can imagine what the vicar was like. But she had a massive line around, and so that's how she started, and then it carried on to me.
You must have been faced with so many sceptics over the years. There are just people who just think it's the load of old cobblers.
Of course, my dad. I'm being honest. My dad, my brother and my son. My son's 16 now. He's grown up with it. But again, he's like, yeah, really? But I'm used to it. And actually, my dad came and saw 9 shows of mine, I don't know, about 7 years ago. And finally he came up to me at the end and he said, I have to believe you. There's no way you can make that stuff up. Mm. So, you know, and I just say to the sceptics, well, it's up to you. You believe in what you want to believe in.
Fair enough.
Yeah.
Do you have voices sort of speaking to you now? Or
I know I'm going to be working with the audience. So I'm going to be tuning into the audience. But it's interesting. May I share what just happened in the corridor?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because we walked in, she said, do you see anything around me? And I'm like, no. Oh, hello, I've got your mum. And we had a little bit of a moment with your mum, actually. And that was beautiful. And she's still around you, you know. It's like, I don't know whether she's making up for lost time, but I just feel as though she's always around you.
Yeah, but I feel that about my parents anyway, that they're there. Because I think you do. That's what you're talking about, thinking about, you know, your inner self.
Yeah.
Do you feel anybody that's died is still with you?
I think you remember them. I remember them and think about them all the time. Yeah, I don't know if they're hovering around me.
But. So I've always felt like my dad is. Yeah. He died in 1979 when I was almost 5, but I always feel like he's here.
Yeah, so there's a man sitting between the two of you, you know, but honestly... It could be your grandfather, though.
Oh.
It could be, because you were quite close to your grandfather.
I was, yeah.
You see, and I feel like it's enough. As much as I want to put it here, I feel as though it's for you.
Oh, really?
Because I feel that you're really close with him, almost like, not saying that he was the man in your life, but it was like you looked up to him as the man. And I keep being shown that he was very, very supportive of you.
He was.
He's super proud
supportive.
Of you.
Yep. Yeah, he made me get piano lessons. So, but apart from that, he was very supportive.
Very. But he wants to pat you on the back, and he's that kind of guy that would pat you on the back and say, go on, go for it. He's a great guy.
Oh,
you look alike as well.
Oh, thank you.